This shipment of giant turbine blades is part of a wind farm project being constructed on the Shetland Islands, a tiny archipelago more than 100 miles north of Scotland in the UK. Its builders say the farm will be the country's most productive onshore wind farm when it's finished in 2024. Yet this remote community in the North Sea, roughly half the size of Rhode Island, is also surrounded by some of Western Europe's largest offshore oil fields. The flow of oil money over the past 50 years has brought jobs and prosperity to the people there, but that flow could soon be more of a trickle. Here's what's at stake as the islands overhaul their economy from relying on fossil fuels to clean energy, and how that plays into a broader energy transition taking place beyond this small corner of the North Sea. The North Sea around Britain is running dry. After about 45 billion barrels of oil have been produced here over the last 50 years, roughly 6 billion barrels are left, according to the North Sea Transition Authority, an industry regulator. That is not even enough to fuel the United States for 1 year. Near Shetland, oil rigs are being scrapped. But the islands have an abundance of another energy source, wind. So, a shift is underway. The Shetland Islands are one of the windiest places in the UK. So windy, in fact, that turbines at the four wind farms currently on Shetland must be stopped at certain times of the day to prevent the local grid from being overloaded.
Shetland's got a really strong wind resource where it sits in the very tip of Scotland. It's got very, very strong winds that then means you're getting high energy from your wind farms. It's also got a lot of infrastructure that's been catered to oil and gas and a lot of expertise.
More windmills are on the way, along with a connection to the national electricity grid. That could enable all households in Shetland, plus 500,000 UK homes, to be powered by wind as soon as construction of the Viking Energy Wind Farm is completed, according to the company behind the project. This shift, though, is not without challenges for Shetland, both onshore and offshore. Local fishers are worried about turbines and undersea cables disrupting fishing waters around Shetland.
If they cordon off an area and put in windmills, then it's unfishable to us, so it's basically taken away our livelihood. It's like saying to a farmer, right, I'm going to take half your field and fence it off. You can't put your sheep or cows there. You can't use it.
Offshore wind farm developers have said that there is an ongoing engagement with the islands.
So there's two key challenges that the offshore wind industry is facing today, and that is ramping up to meet government targets that are set in place for net zero. It takes roughly, 5 years to build your project, to get through permitting stages and actually bring that project online. So if you're wanting to meet that 2030 target, you need to be planning these projects now. And then also cost challenges, where we're looking at inflation and the increasing cost of capital expenditure.
Keeping one hand on the oil drill then can seem quite appealing. And amid protests by climate activists, in July, Britain committed to granting hundreds of new licenses for oil and gas extraction.
Well, it's great to be in Scotland to strengthen our energy security with more licences for the North Sea, but also speed us on our way to net zero with carbon capture and storage.
It's no secret that the margins are lower in offshore wind than they are in oil and gas, and that does pose a problem for these kind of rural communities that are very reliant on established oil and gas hubs.
But worldwide, winds are changing. The US aims to have 30 gigawatts of wind power installed in its seas by the end of the decade, enough to power roughly all of Texas. In Europe, the number of offshore turbines is set to increase by nearly 400% over the same period. The Shetland Islands are well placed to help meet that growing demand, but as a broader energy transition gears up and seas become more crowded, the next challenge will be for new and old industries to find a way to coexist.